Mary, could you really be in this town?
Silent Hill 2 is a classic that has become a staple of psychological horror games since its original release in 2001. While the game was originally released on the PlayStation 2, there are several options to experience it on PC. In this video, we'll compare four different ways to play Silent Hill 2 on PC and try to find the best one. So let's get started. First, let's check out the PlayStation 2 Greatest Hits version of Silent Hill 2 running on PCSX2, the PS2 emulator.
In my restless dreams, I see that town, Silent Hill.
The Greatest Hits version is the best on PS2 because it includes all of the extra content included in the ports that were released after the original PS2 version. But regardless of which release you choose, the PlayStation 2 version of Silent Hill 2 is the original release, and therefore the most authentic representation of the game. It is the only version that includes 60fps FMV cutscenes, and has the best looking fog effect. However, it is limited to a 4:3 aspect ratio and 30fps, which may feel outdated for some people. Also, the per-vertex lighting used for the flashlight is inferior to the per-pixel lighting used in other versions. When played on PCSX2, it reproduces all the visual effects correctly, including the iconic fog, and offers enhancements such as increased rendering resolution all the way up to 4K and beyond. While PCSX2 offers a widescreen hack, using it is not recommended as it shows parts of the screen that are not properly rendered. The same goes for the 60fps cheat code that is available for this game. It will break the cutscene audio and introduce other gameplay issues, so it should be avoided. Another thing to note is that when increasing the resolution, the soft shadows become sharper, and the text looks pixelated regardless of their high resolution.
Ow! Hey, wait!
Also, this version uses the pressure sensitivity on PlayStation 2 controllers to differentiate between light and heavy attacks. However, PCSX2 allows you to use a pressure modifier button on modern controllers to overcome this. In this footage, I'm using DualSense, which does not have pressure-sensitive buttons, to demonstrate the pressure modifier feature. I've picked L3 as a pressure modifier, and when holding it, the attack button will register the modified sensitivity. Although honestly, you don't even need this to play this game, as using only heavy melee attacks is perfectly viable. One last thing to note about PCSX2 is that it supports texture packs. And in this video, I've used an HD texture pack made by Ice Bullet. A link to it is in the description. And here are the settings I've used for this video. Despite its downsides, PCSX2 remains a great option, especially for those seeking a truly authentic PlayStation 2 experience.
It's hard to see with this fog, but there's only the one road. You can't miss it.
Thanks.
Next, let's take a look at the Xbox version of Silent Hill 2 running on Xemu, the Xbox emulator.
Mary.
The Xbox version of Silent Hill 2 is a port from the PlayStation 2 version, boasting improved per-pixel lighting for the flashlight and smoother looking text. However, it suffers from downgraded fog effects, lower audio quality, and lower quality FMV cutscenes at 30fps compared to PS2. It's still limited to 4:3 and 30fps, much like the PS2 version. Xemu runs this version on PC with minimal visual glitches, except for the flashlight shining light backwards. While Xemu supports resolution increase, performance may be hindered. On my PC, which is an i5-9600K and an RTX 2060 Super, I see performance drops in gameplay sections with the flashlight when the resolution is too high. Also, the emulator lacks hacks for widescreen or 60fps, as far as I know. Anyway, here are the settings I've used for this video. Considering all the downgrades and poor performance at high resolution, I'd say this is not a good way to play this game. Still, it's definitely not the worst option, as you'll find out in a moment. The next option we're going to check out is the PlayStation 3 version of Silent Hill 2 from the HD Collection, running on RPCS3, the PlayStation 3 emulator.
There's only the one road. You can't miss it.
Thanks.
But...
Yes?
As you may have heard before, the Silent Hill HD Collection is an infamous, extremely poor release by Konami. It was basically a rushed remaster project outsourced to a studio named Hijinx, which had no experience with AAA horror games. The result was a complete mess. It has lots of ugly remade textures which miss the visual identity of the original, broken effects like the fog, dynamic shadows,
hey, wait!
Damn it.
And flashlights lens flares,
I think you better get out of here soon.
Glitches like wrong sound effects, flickering shadows, and a general washed out look. The only upgrade is support for 16x9 widescreen, although the FMV cutscenes are stretched. As for the emulation on RPCS3, although RPCS3 allows for the games to run well, with occasional 60fps performance, it randomly limits the game to 30fps in certain areas. It doesn't seem to have any emulation glitches though, only the ones present in the PS3 game itself. Anyway, here are the settings I've used for this video if you really wanted. Despite the relatively glitch-free emulation, the inherent problems in the HD collection make this option undesirable to say the least. Basically, this is the worst way to play Silent Hill 2 on PC for sure. And by the way, I was also going to include the Xbox 360 version of Silent Hill 2 from the HD collection running on Xenia in this video, but thankfully, it does not work at all on Xenia, so I didn't even have to play that for a second. Anyway, let's move on to the last option. Last, but definitely not least, is the PC version.
Is this the right way? Yeah. It's hard to see with this.
The PC version was a port from the Xbox version released in 2002, and as expected from a PC game from that era, it is full of problems. Those include broken gamma levels, which makes it look too bright, broken audio engine, which causes music to play incorrectly and cutscene audio to not play at all, resolution options limited to 1600 by 1200, frame rate limited to 30fps and aspect ratio limited to 4x3, no modern controller support and poor keyboard controls, broken visual effects like missing depth of field, motion blur and smooth shadows, and all of the downgrades of the Xbox version, like worse looking fog effects, and lower quality 30fps FMV cutscenes. However, thanks to one of the best community patches of all time, the PC version can be fully fixed and enhanced.
Mary, could you really be in this town?
The mod is called Silent Hill 2 Enhanced Edition, and it fixes all the glitches and missing effects, adds support for modern controllers, and includes various enhancements, such as AI upscaled FMV cutscenes, improved fog effects that match the PlayStation 2 version, proper 16x9 widescreen support, 60fps support without any glitches.
What the hell is it? It's not human.
Higher quality images fully remade from scratch, high resolution text font, and many more. With the Enhanced Edition mod, the PC version surpasses all other options in terms of visual quality and modern conveniences. It makes the PC version the definitive way to play Silent Hill 2 today. The only minor downside is the FMV cutscenes, which are still 30fps.
Like your girlfriend?
The settings I've used for this video were all at default, with the resolution being set to 4K and the frame rate set to 60fps. After evaluating all the options, it is evident that the PC version with the Enhanced Edition mod offers the most superior and immersive Silent Hill 2 experience on PC. With the mod's remarkable enhancements and fixes, it provides players with a visually stunning and smoother gameplay experience. However, for those specifically seeking a retro-looking, low-resolution experience similar to the original PlayStation 2 release, the PCSX2 emulator with the PlayStation 2 version might be the preferred choice.
I'm not lying!
In any case, Silent Hill 2 is still a chilling masterpiece that can be experienced greatly on PC. Whether you've never played it before or are looking to relive those memories, you're in for an unforgettable psychological horror experience. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe for more videos like this. If you want to get in touch with me, follow me on Twitter. Anyway, thanks for watching and I'll see you on the next one.
Oh,
my name is Maria. I don't look like a ghost, do I? See? Feel how warm I am?
You're really not Mary.
I told you, I'm Maria.
Sorry. I was confused.
Where are you going?
I'm looking for Mary. Have you seen her?
Didn't you say she died?